everybody. This is Seth Isaacson at Rock Island Auction Company, here to talk to you about some of the firearms coming up in our May 2nd through 5th Premier Firearms Auction. We've got a lot of flintlock pistols coming up, and those are what get me pretty excited. So I've got a selection of them here today. We've got a lot more than this coming up in the auction. So definitely check out the catalog, both online and in print, for all the technical details and the wide selection. Most of the time when people think about flintlock pistols, they think of a standard muzzle-loading flintlock pistol, kind of like these pairs. Obviously, these two pairs are a little more ornate than a plain military pistol, but they got this basic structure of a standard flintlock pistol. You know, they're loaded from the front, put the powder and the ball down the muzzle, powder in the pan, pretty simple, straightforward. But even really early on, they had a lot of ingenious ways to improve flintlock pistols and make them more useful, because obviously having only one shot per gun makes it slow on the firing, can get you in a tight spot in combat. So we've got examples like this one here, where they've actually designed the gun to have two barrels. As you can see, it's not actually much bigger than a single barrel pistol. And in this example, they use two locks, one on each side. And on the right lock fires the upper barrel with the front trigger. The left lock is going to fire the lower barrel. And to do that, if you look at the vent right here, it's actually much lower in the pan than you'd see in a normal flintlock pistol, but that'd still work. And that would allow you to get two shots off really quick. A pistol like this would have probably been carried on horseback given how big it is. Obviously, it's pretty hard to load while on a horse. So we have double barrel pistols like this where they use two separate locks in stationary barrels. And we also have what are called swivel breech pistols, also known as Wender pistols, which just means swivel in German. On these pistols, you actually use a single lock, but there's actually two frizzens and two flash pans, one for each barrel. And by pulling on this little trigger at the front of the trigger guard, you can rotate the barrels. So all you'd really have to do to take two shots is, I mean, you'd fire, cock the hammer back, swivel, and you could shoot again very fast. That allowed you to only have one lock, which makes it a little more compact. And as you can see, like, one of the reasons I picked this pistol is actually because they have some really ornate work on them as well. I mean, they've got silver mounts, gold accents, really fine engraving. So they're just a beautiful example of these pistols. A lot of these are a little more plain, but this pair is actually very ornate. So that's two ways to handle it in a large form. There's actually several other ways you can handle any multi-shots out of a flintlock pistol. And one of which is on this little tiny pair here. So these are from the early 19th century. It's kind of like concealed carry circa 1800. On this pair, you got a single, you know, box lock action, single frizzen. But if you look carefully at the pan, this pan rotates via this little lever on the side. When it's closed like this, it would just fire the upper barrel. And when you turn it like this, there's a hole in the bottom of the pan, actually, and that would then fire the lower barrel. And that actually will hold two powder charges in there, a smaller powder charge for the lower barrel. So this pistol, especially when you have a pair, would actually allow you to have four shots instead of a single shot or just two shots with a small pair of pistols. And unlike the rest of these pistols here, this pair is also breech loading, which people often don't think about when they think about flintlock pistols. They usually assume, you know, flintlock muzzle loader. But on these, the barrels actually screw off, which would allow you to put the powder into this chamber, lay the ball on top, and then screw them back on top. So there's obviously a few advantages of them being breech loading. For one, that makes it pretty easy to reload. You don't need as much equipment. You don't need a ramrod. You just need the powder and the ball. And that also allows you to get a tighter ball to bore fit, which actually creates more velocity, which is very helpful when you have a barrel that short, because obviously you don't have much time for the powder to burn and create power. So this would actually be a very handy pistol if you were, you know, walking the streets of London and were worried about highwaymen or something like that. So the final pair I got here is actually my favorite of these pistols, and I'll show you a few reasons why. So this is a classic Queen Anne pistol. One of the hallmarks of those is, of course, the overall design, the way the lock and the barrel are designed. They are breech loaders like the previous pair, so that's helpful. Allows you to get a little more power out of them. And as you can see, that's a pretty big bore for a relatively small pistol. But my favorite thing about these is they have one of the classic grotesque mask pommel caps on the pistol. And for some reason, this is just the one that I find to be the most attractive. And it's in silver. I mean, it's interesting. It's kind of gnarly. It's kind of scary. And I don't know, I think that's just an interesting aspect of an otherwise kind of pretty pistol. But you know, these things are meant to do damage. So to have something kind of scary on it's kind of neat to me. So if you look at this one compared to this previous example, the first one I showed you, I mean, it's got a cool mask. It's really neat. It's still an interesting example of how much variety there are in these designs. But this one's almost like comical on one level compared to that one, where in my mind, it's a little more like kind of frightening. Well, thanks for tuning in, guys. This is, like I said before, this is a small selection of the wide variety of flintlock pistols and other firearms we have coming up in our next Premier Firearms auction. You can come in on preview day on May 2nd and check all these guns and thousands more out. And then, of course, the auction dates are May 3rd, 4th, and 5th. Thank you very much, and take care.